सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमास्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिनी व्योमोद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनमुभुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं वेदागुश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुं हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। कामनायान्त्यं संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। The next adhikarana, Shrestanutvadhikarana, is introduced in the vritti as na kevalam deha dharanam eva asya asadharanam apitu anyad apityah. The earlier adhikarana said that prana is in swarupa, not vayu and not kriya. So what was questioned is, okay, if prana is not vayu and it is not indriya kriya, then what is it? Is it swatantra or is it karana? So it is not swatantra like jiva, but it is karana of the jiva, and not karana like chakshu exactly. So chakshuradi vach karanatvam, but akaranatvam also, thereby upakaranatvam of prana was established. Then the question was whether like chakshuradi Indriyas or Karanas have their swaswa vishayas. Does prana have its own vishaya? Prana doesn't have its vishaya, although it is an upakarna. It is a karana, but it is an upakarna. It does not have its vishaya, but it has its own functionality by panchavritti bheda. Jivadharana is, not jivadharana, dehadharana. Dehadi dharana, akhya vyapara is its samanya. Not samanya, as compared to the indriyadi karanas, they have their asadharana vyapara. Similarly, asadharana vyapara of prana as karana upakarana is dehadi dharana. And then samanyataha also you can see from the perspective of the pancha prana, samanya prana vyapara is deha dharana. Then vishesha can be seen as pancha vritti having their own pancha prana vritti having their specific functionality. So now the next adhikarana is shrestanutva adhikarana, where the prana bheda is going to be discussed. सो न केवलं देहधारणम् एव अस्य असाधारणम् अस्य कस्य प्राणस्य प्राणस्य असाधारणम् किम् असाधारणम् व्यापारः देहधारणम् एव न व्हाट एल्स इज देयर अपि तु अन्यदपि सम अदर व्यापार इज आल्सो देयर नॉट ओनली देहधारण सो दि प्राण व्यापाराज आर डिस्कस्ड विशेष व्यापाराज पंचवृत्तिर्मनोवत् व्यपदिश्यते पंचवृत्तिर्मनोवद् व्यपदिश्यते। सो फाइव वृत्तीज आर देर, फाइव वृत्तीज ऑफ प्राण, प्राण अपान व्यान उदान समान भेदात, वेरियस वृत्तीज आर देर एंड बेस्ड ऑन फंक्शनलिटी देर इज विशेष व्यापार ऑल्सो। सो पंच वृत्ति इंद्रियवत करणत्वम उपकरणत्वम एंड मनोवत पंचवृत्ति प्राण पंचवृत्ति पंचवृत्ति इज अ बहुरी समास ऑल्दो वृत्ति शब्द इज तिन्नंत एंड बीइंग तिन्नंत इट इज स्त्रीलिंग शब्द बट स्टिल पंचवृत्ति प्राण व्हेन यू से मुख्य प्राण पंचवृत्ति देन पंच वृत्तयः यस्य प्राणस्य सः प्राणः पंचवृत्ति देयर बाय पंचवृत्ति शब्द विल बिकम पुल्लिंग लाइक प्राण शब्द. सो पंचवृत्ति मनोवत लाइक दि मनस अंतकरण इज ऑल्सो वॉट हैज फोर भेदास बेस्ड ऑन दि फंक्शनलिटी वी से मनस इट्सेल्फ बिहेव्स लाइक दि मनस अंतकरण इट्सेल्फ बिहेव्स लाइक मनस बुद्धि चित्त एंड अहंकार अहंकृति. सो दैट इज वन वे ऑफ डिवाइडिंग दि अंतकरण. सिमिलरली मनोवत व्हेन इट इज सेड देन माइंड इट्सेल्फ फर्दर कैन बी डिवाइडेड इनटू एज मेनी वृत्तिज आर देयर एज मेनी इमोशंस आर देयर एज मेनी थॉट्स आर देयर सो मेनी वृत्तिज आर गोइंग ऑन घटवृत्ति पटवृत्ति विषय भेदात ऑल्सो. सो सो मेनी वेराइटीज ऑफ वृत्तिज आर अवेलेबल. दि माइंड इट्सेल्फ टेक्स दोज फॉर्म्स देयर फोर वृत्तिभेदात मनोभेद मनोवत. सो सिमिलरली प्राण ऑल्सो लाइक माइंड टेक्स दि डिफरेंट वृत्तिज बेस्ड ऑन द डिफरेंट वृत्तिज डिफरेंट फंक्शनलिटीज टेक्स अ डिफरेंट फॉर्म एंड देयर बाय दे आर नेम डिफरेंटली व्यपदिश्यते एंड इट इज टॉट सो इन दि उपनिषद्स इन दि श्रुति. सो दैट इज दि सूत्रार्थ यथा मनः अनेक वृत्तिभेदेन व्यपदिश्यते तथा प्राणोपि पंचवृत्तिभेदेन व्यपदिश्यते. दिस इज सम वृत्ति वी कैन मेक एज टू द माइंड द वे द माइंड इज टॉट एज हैविंग वेरियस वृत्तिज भेदास एज हैविंग भेदास बेस्ड ऑन द वेरियस वृत्तिज. सिमिलरली प्राण इज ऑल्सो टॉट एज हैविंग फाइव फोल्ड भेदास बेस्ड ऑन द फाइव फंक्शनलिटीज फाइव वृत्तिज. यथा मनः अनेक वृत्त्याख्य असाधारण व्यापार अपेक्षया अनेकधा व्यपदिश्यते. द माइंड इज टॉट टू बी इन मेनी फॉर्म्स अनेकधा अनेक प्रकारेण व्यपदिश्यते. इज टॉट एज हैविंग मेनी आकाराज मेनी फॉर्म्स इन मल्टीफोल्ड मैनर द माइंड एग्जिस्ट बाय अनेक वृत्त्याख्य असाधारण व्यापार अपेक्षया. कीपिंग इन माइंड the different vyaparas which are asadharana only to the mind. If you are seeing a particular object, then chakshurindriya connection with the rupa of the vishaya is asadharana to chakshurindriya. The shrotrindriya has no access there, but the mind does have access there. Similarly, Shrotrendriya, when it is accessing Shabda, that time, that is the Asadharana Dharma of the Shrotrendriya, where the other Indriyas, Chakshuradi Indriyas, do not have access. But the Antakkarana mind has to be backing, therefore, the mind has access there, Manas as Vritti. So, Shabdakara Vritti takes place. Earlier to that, when the Chakshurindriya was connected in that example, the rupakara vritti takes place. So the antakkarana asadharana dharma is to have various vrittis based on the indriyas or without the indriya vishayas also, kalpita vishayas also in the mind where we are daydreaming or in the swapnavastha also generating sharira with tattad indriyas and tattad vishayas, the antakkarana rejoices there. So to say, if you personify the antakkarana, basically antakkarana vrittis are there in jagratavastha and swapnavastha, that is the asadharana vyapara of the antakkarana or the manas. So aneka vrittyakhya, which are called as vrittis, which are many, called as akhya. So aneka vrittyakhya asadharana vyapara, it is not common to anyone else, it is specific only to the antakkarana manas. एंड तदा अपेक्षया अनेकधा व्यपदिश्यते. कीपिंग इन माइंड सच वृत्तिज आर मेनी दि मनस इज टॉट टू बी इन दोज मेनी वेज. एवं उच्छ्वास निश्वास सर्वशरीर क्रियोत्क्रांत्याख्य आख्याः चत्वारः व्यापारः. देर आर फोर व्यापारास विच आर वॉट उच्छ्वास निश्वास inhaling, exhaling, and then sarva sharira kriya, all the activities of the sharira That is the third Vyapara, and the fourth is Utkranti. Utkranti meaning the when the prana helps the unacceptable food to be thrown out. You try to eat something which is not acceptable to the sharira in that particular condition, whether it is poisonous or whether it is not agreeable to the current configuration of the body. Can be based on mind also, but then it triggers a particular reaction in the body. So for example, imagine the food that you like. Let's say you like sweets or fried food, fast food. So all of this we are interested to have only when the swasthya is there. When we are not disturbed by anything else, the body is fine comparatively, and then we indulge in our desires to eat a particular kind of a food. Now when the body is not well, when there is a fever, then what happens? First the main switch is turned off by the body itself. Bhagavan has made the body in such a manner that whenever there is fever, etc., meaning the body is weak, it cannot defend itself, already being attacked, that time the main switch is switched off. The tongue is the main switch. It does not allow you to eat anything and everything, whether you like it or not. The main switch is off. You cannot let the body take anything. So therefore a person who has fever says, whatever I like, I don't want it now. Give me something, give some ganji or something. Just that too forcibly has to be fed, because antibiotics have to be taken. They'll eat up the body, so you have to eat something. So very less, but food that is going to nourish the body. If at all somebody says, no, I like this, whether or not I have fever, I'm going to eat sweets and I'm going to eat fried food, then the body is protected. Even when the main switch is off, you try to force feed yourself with what you like, what happens is that the udana functionary of the prana will throw up. So that is the function there of utkranti. And also on the drop of the body, meaning maranavastha, udana helps the jiva leave the sharira. So these are the four chatvaraha vyapara, kasya mukhya pranaseva vritti bhedena. So chaturvida vritti bhedena chatvaraha vyapara. Then the fifth vyapara is what panchavritti has been said, bhakshita annadi rasanam samatvena sarvangeshu nayanam panchamo vyaparaha. The fifth vyapara is to spread the nourishment to the entire body, which is extracted from the food and water or liquid which has been partaken. So that is samana. So tana peksha panchavrittihi. Considering this five functions, prana is what? Panchavritti. Panchavritti pranaha vyapadishyate. This is how prana has been described in the shastra. Kramena and in sequence, respectively, what are these? Ushvasa, nishvasa, sarva sharira kriya, utkranti akhya, and bhakshita annadi rasanam samatvena sarvangeshu nayanam. These are the five vyaparas. Respectively, they belong to which division of prana? Kramena pranaha apanaha vyanaha udana samana iti. So prana is for ushvasa. Prana manages ushvasa, apanaha nishvasa, then vyana sarva sharira kriya, udanaha utkranti, and samana bhakshita annadi rasanam samatvena sarvangeshu nayanam. Tad asadharana vyapara apekshaya jivopakaranattvam manovaditi siddham. Therefore Purvapakshi, who has been questioning as to prana cannot be karana, prana cannot be limited also. First he showed the virodha between prana being limited and limitless. He also said that prana is described as vayu at some places it is separated from vayu, so bheda bheda shruti virodha. Then he said that this prana cannot be karana. If it is karana, it has to be swatantra like jiva, it would be swatantra like jiva, that is anishta. Now he is refuted and is told that prana is as described in the shastra panchavrittihi, and that is the asadharana vyapara of prana for the purpose of the jiva. It is not independent, it is only for the purpose of the jiva. As long as prarabdha is there, the deha should be retained. That is the asadharana vyapara of prana. And further, within the sharira, it has five different functions. Thereby, like manas, it is also karana to the jiva, upakarana to the jiva. Iti siddham, this is established. Ittham mukhya pranasi utpattim swarupam cha abhidhaya parimanam atideshena aha. So there is an atidesha. Parimana. Parimana is the size. What is the size of this prana? Meaning, is there a size that can be discussed? Or is there a particular form? You can say form or akara of prana. So ittham mukhya pranasya utpattim swarupam cha abhidhaya. Having discussed the utpatti of prana, prana does have utpatti, it has been established. Therefore, it is not nitya, it is anitya. So that virodha is discounted. Then swarupam, what is the swarupa of prana? That has been discussed. Having discussed that, parimanam atideshenaha. Atidesha is to extend it to the extend whatever has been discussed, it is being extended. So extending the same, the next sutra, parimanam atideshena. What is the parimana size of this prana? Thereby shrestha anutva adhikaranam. What was the earlier adhikarana? I'm sorry. So the earlier adhikarana was we had one sutra left. Sorry. So the earlier adhikarana was the vayukriya adhikarana. The next adhikarana that comes up is shrestha anutva adhikarana. I jumped the gun with the last sutra. So this adhikarana, first sutra is anushcha. Anushcha. Simple sutra, and we have studied this. We have studied this when indriyas were seen. Anavahacha. So we have seen this anavascha. Anavascha sutra 247. So pranaha, there the word of pranaha, which was in the sutra. Tatha pranaha, the first sutra. Pranaha in the sutra was in the meaning of indriyas. So anavascha pranaha, meaning indriyas are anu, they are sukshma. Similarly here, this mukhya prana, this prana is in the swartha. So prana anushcha, prana is also anu. What is the parimana of prana? Anu. It is not vibhu, it is anu. Anu does not mean paramanu, anu is just a size which is limited to the sharira there. So pranasya antaranga swarupa kathananantaram. If you have to make a vritti, what you should say? You can say indriyani yatha anavaha tatha pranaha anuhu. And cha, with cha you can say sukshmascha. It is not a vibhu padartha. Prana is not a vibhu padartha. And prana is also sukshma. So anu can mean sukshma also. So thereby cha can be read. That is the sutra artha. Vritti is what? Pranasya antaranga swarupa kathananantaram. What is the swarupa of the prana? Antaranga swarupa. What is the real swarupa of prana? Meaning, prana swarupa has been discussed in two manners, in two ways. One is bahiranga and other is antaranga. Bahiranga meaning, not bahiranga really, but considering the mukhya prana as jivagata, but still not divided into fivefold. So before being divided into fivefold vrittis, based on vrittis, prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana, what is the mukhya prana, which is tattat sharira gata. That prana, which can be seen as the dhatvartha, from the dhatvartha, jiva prana dharane. So that which makes the jiva hold on to the sharira, that prana, you flip the dhatvartha. Dhatvartha is jiva, is who holds the prana. So that prana which the jiva holds, as long as the prarabdha is there, so that he can stay in the sharira, that prana is discussed first, and then with panchavritti bheda, various five functions are also asadharana vyapara of this prana. So that is the antaranga vyapara, antaranga swarupa. So pranasya antaranga swarupa kathananantaram panchavritti bhedena ityartha. Then bahiranga parimanam atidishyate. What is the bahiranga, meaning outside the sharira, what is the prana swarupa? Bahiranga parimanam atidishyate. So outside the sharira also, what is the size of this prana? Within the sharira, is it limited to the sharira, or does it pervade across the sharira? What is this swarupa of prana? Bahiranga parimanam atirishyate iti antaranga bahiranga rakshana sangatihi purvenasya bodhya. So, sangati has not been mentioned initially, but in the vritti, what is said is that you can see this sutra as having a sangati with the earlier, as to earlier adhikarana talked about the antaranga swarupa of prana. Now the bahiranga swarupa of the prana is being discussed. उत्क्रांत्यादि श्रुतेः समये विस्त्रिभिः लोकैः इत्यादि प्राणविभुत्व श्रुतेश्च मितो विरोध अस्ति न वा इति संदेहे अस्ति इति पूर्वपक्षः. नाउ उत्क्रांत्यादि श्रुति, देयर इज श्रुति विच टॉक्स अबाउट उत्क्रांति. प्राण इज दैट विच हेल्प्स, विच इज इन द शरीर, होल्ड द शरीर, बट आफ्टर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ द शरीर, keeping it alive and taking care of through all the functions, all the five functions, taking care of the sharira, helping it live, helping the jiva live by upakarana, being an upakarana, assisting the jiva. This prana finally helps the jiva live the sharira. That is the utkranti shruti, utkranti adi shruti. All the various functions are taught, but the important part is that prana also has utkranti. And Utkranti Shruti is what in the Prana Samvada also, Prana tries to leave the body, then all the Indriyas say, okay, no, no, please come back, we agree that you are Shrestha. So in the Shrestatva discussion, we have seen that Prana Samvada, Chandogya Prana Samvada. So there also Utkranti, Prana leaves the Sharira, tries to leave the Sharira. That shows what? Pranasya Anuttvam. And Samaye Vistribhir Lokaihi. Samaha, eshaha, pranaha, this prana is what? Samaha, is samana, to what? Compared to, with this samaha, ebihi tribhi lokaihi. Prana is samana to, sama, samana to all the three lokas. Imagine this, this prana who is going to leave an individual body on the drop of the body on in marana avastha, that prana is what? Samaha evi tribhilokaihi, is same as this or similar to the three worlds. So what kind of a contradictory statement is made by Shruti at two different places? Utkranti, what utkranti is possible for someone who is trailokya parimana? So trailokya parimana at one place and at other place utkranti from one sharira. Therefore, ityadi prana vibhutva shrutescha. There is an utkrantyadi shruti, which is what? Anutva shruti. And prana vibhutva shruti is samaye vistribhi lokaihi. Thereby, ityadi prana vibhutva shrutescha mitho virodha astinavayati sandhe. Mutually, are they contradictory to each other or not? Definitely contradictory, says the Purvapaksha. Asti iti Purvapaksha. Siddhantastu. Siddhanti says, chakshuradivat prana api anu. So, chakshuradivat prana api anu. Parichinnaha sukshmascha. So anuscha means what? Anu means parichinna. Parichinna parimana. And anu also has the meaning of sukshma. So sukshmascha. By chakarat you can repeat that anuhu. And anu, again anu what? Sukshmaha. Parichinnaha sukshmascha. Is very subtle. Prana is very subtle is the meaning there. And parichinna is limited also. Par deha limited. Prana is limited. Like what? Chakshuradivati. Indriyas are limited. Similarly, prana is also limited in size and also subtle. Then what about this shruti? Samayebhi iti. Earlier we have seen Indriyas are limited. Then what about the Indriyas being seen? Pranaha. Indriyas are also seen as Vibhu in some Shruti. There it was said it is for Upasana. Now what about this Prana? Who is said to be Samaha Ebhi? So Samaha Ebhi Ityadi Shruti hi Sakala Vayu Para. That is talking about Sakala Vayu. Which is that? So if you look at the Sharira of an individual, Vyashti Sharira, then Prana is limited. If you look at the Virat Sharira, Hiranyagarbha Sharira, there what should you say? That Sharira also has Prana, right? It is that Prana seen from the Samashti Drishti. There the Prana will be limited not to an individual Sharira, but to the Samashti Sharira. There you should say what? It is Sakala Vayu Para. That Prana is Sakala Vayu Para. The Shruti is Sakala Vayu Para, which is discussing Samaye Bhi Trivi Loke, because the three Lokas, Lokas can be seen as with the division of 14 Lokas, or all 14 are contained in three Lokas. So when three Lokas are discussed, they mean all the 14 Lokas. So these three Lokas, Karma Bhumi being in the middle, and then below and above you can consider all of these Lokas to be included, or Sapta Loka also, Sapta Loka or you know Chaturdasha Loka or three Lokas, they all really mean similar things, similar ideas as to all the Lokas. Sometimes Talas are not counted, but then otherwise they have similar meaning. So Sama Ebihi Trivihi Lokaihi Iti Shrutihi Sakala Vayupara. That Shruti is focused on what? That Vayu which is there everywhere, and that Vayu Rupa Prana, meaning which has not become Prana for an individual Sharira yet. Or at the Samashti level it has become that Vayu has entered all Shariras and has become Prana in Tattat Sharira. Then when you put together from the Samashti, it will be Sakala Vayu Para Shrutihi Na Adhyatmika Prana Matra Para Iti Anayoho Na Virodha Iti Siddham. So Anayoho Virodha Nasti, Vibhutva Shruti and Utkranti Shruti has no Virodha at all, because the Utkranti Shruti is talking about Adhyatmika Prana, which is talking about an individual Prana, whereas this Vibhutva Shruti Samayebhi Ityadi, that Shruti is Sakala Vayu Para, it is looking at the Samashti Drishti, so thereby there is no Virodha between them. It is Siddham, it is established in this manner. Pranasya Adhyatmadhidayata Vibhagena Anutva Vibhutva Nirupana Prasangena Adhyatmikanam Indriyanam Adhidayokadi Adhishthitanam Cheshtam Achashteti Prasanga Sangatya Idamaha. So Pranasya Adhyatma Adhidaivata Vibhagena. With the Adhyatma Adhidaivata. Pranasya Adhyatma and Adhidaivata Vibhagena. With the division in which manner? Adhyatma and Adhidaiva. So Adhyatma is individual, related to a particular individual, particular Jiva. And Adhidaivata is what? Look at the Devata Drishti, that is the Devata who is connected to that Indriya or particular Prana or some particular Karana. So we have these Adhishtatru Devatas there. Now if you look at the Samashti Drishti there, the Devata who is connected to, take a single Adhishtatra Devata, single Adhishtatra Devata who blesses the Indriyas. For example, Chakshuho Suryaha. Surya is that Devata who is connected to Chakshurindriya of all Jivas, who blesses all the Chakshurindriyas, helps the eyes see. Therefore, if eyes are weak, the vision is weak, then one should do Surya Upasana, Surya Stotra Ityadi. Generally for health, but then specifically for the Chakshurindriya becoming powerful. So one should do Surya Stuti, Surya, worship of Surya, Aditya Devata. Why? Because he is the Adhishtatra Devata for each and every individual Jiva's Chakshurindriya. So adhyatma is my own chakshur indriya. I see, my indriyas help me. But from the perspective of devata, that devata is blessing, without his blessings the chakshur indriya cannot function. The eyes may be there, golakas may be there, indriyas may not be there. Indriyas may be there, but shakti may not be there. So adhidevata vibhagina anutvaivotva. Now if you look at the perspective of the surya devata, what will happen? Surya devata is not connected to only an individual chakshur, but to all chakshus of all jivas, not only human beings but also birds, birds, animals, etc., amphibians. So the perspective has been shown to be different in the case of prana as what? Sakala vayu para, or the shruti which is vibhutva shruti, and then utkranti shruti is adhyatmika prana para. So now pranasya, taking prana, so we took the chakshuradi example. Now prana, adhyatmika prana and adhidhaivata perspective has been shown there, and thereby anutva and vibhutva has been seen to be valid. Both anutva and vibhutva is valid. So perspective difference is there. Anutva of prana is valid by looking at the adhyatma, adhyatma drushtya, and vibhutva is valid by adhidhaivata drushti. So anutva vibhutva nirupana prasangena adhyatmikanam indriyanam, these indriyas which are individuals indriyas at the vyashti level, adhidaivikadi adhishtitanam cheshtam achashte. Now these adhidaivika, which are from the devata perspective, you look at it, they are connected to all the indriyas of all the not all the indriyas, particular indriyas that they particularly are adhishtatru devatas of. They are connected to all jivas with that particular indriya in consideration. Similarly, a different devata who presides over a different indriya is connected to that indriya, but in all jivas. So thereby adhishtitanam adhidaivikadi adhishtitanam cheshtam achashte iti prasanga sangatya idamaha. So now the prasanga sangati is, the current prasanga is what? Anutva yuvutva nirupana prasanga, which went by. Now the next prasanga in continuation is what? Okay, anutva and yuvutva has been talked about prana from the perspective of individual and the samashti or the devata, vyashti samashti bheda. Then indriyas also can be seen with the vyashti samashti bheda perspective change, and thereby the prasanga sangati is the connection between the earlier and the current adhikaranam. This is the jyotiradhyadhikaranam. Jyotiradhyadhisthanam tu tadamananat. Jyotiradhyadhisthanam tu tadamananat. So the sutra says jyotiradhi adhisthanam tu tadamananat. There is no padachheda there. Tadamananat is also samasa tasya amananat. Tasya shravanat ityartha. Because of such a shruti statement. What is that? Tu jyotiradi adhishtanam. Jyotiradhyadhishtanam. Jyoti is aditya. Adhishtanam here can be seen as preranam. Adhishtatru devata gives prerana to the indriyas to work. So this surya devata, aditya devata, gives adhishtana, becomes an adhishtana and gives prerana. Prerana to the chakshur indriya to function in an individual, and from the samashti level all indriyas in all chakshur indriyas in all jivas, all pranis. So jyotiradhyadhishtanam adhishtanam means what? Adityadi preranam tu tadamananat tasya amananat kutrasti adityaschakshuhu iti tadamananat tasyamananat. So jyotiradhyadhishtanam adityadi preranam tu adityaschakshuhu iti tasyamananat. That is the sutrartha. Because aditya is, surya is the चक्षु, चक्षु मीनिंग चक्षुर इंद्रिय अधिष्ठात्र देवता, दैट इज द मीनिंग देयर. आदित्य चक्षु मीन्स वॉट? आदित्य इज नॉट सूर्य लिटरली, आई मीन आदित्य इज सूर्य इज नॉट चक्षुर इंद्रिय लिटरली, बट ही इज द वन हू इज अधिष्ठात्र देवता फॉर ऑल चक्षुर इंद्रियाज, दैट इज द मीनिंग देयर. एंड ड्यू टू दैट श्रुति ज्योतिरादि अधिष्ठानम, देयर फॉर वॉट? आदित्यादि प्रेरणम, देयर इज प्रेरणा फॉर द इंद्रियाज, दैट इज द मीनिंग देयर. दैट इज सूत्रार्थ. वृत्ति सेज अत्र आदित्यश्चक्षुर्भूत्वा इत्यादि इंद्रियाणां देवताधीन चेष्टावत्त्वश्रुतेः चक्षुषाहि रूपाणि पश्यति इति श्रुत्या विरोध अस्ति न वा इति संदेहे अस्ति इति पूर्वपक्ष अविरोध अध्याय. देयरफॉर पूर्वपक्षी हैज टू शो सम विरोधा विच हैज टू बी काउंटर्ड हियर. सो इन दिस सूत्र व्हाट इज बीइंग काउंटर्ड इन दिस अधिकरण, विरोधा पॉइंटेड आउट बाय द पूर्वपक्षी. व्हाट इज द विरोधा? ही सेज आदित्यश्चक्षुर्भूत्वा इज वन श्रुति विच सेज दैट द सूर्य हिमसेल्फ आदित्य देवता बिकम्स द चक्षुरिंद्रिया. He is not Chakshurindriya, but he becomes the Chakshurindriya when it is said, then Aditya is going to see. Who is going to see? If Aditya becomes the Chakshurindriya, then Chakshurindriya is seeing. That's what you have to say. And Aditya, Surya has become Chakshurindriya. So Chakshurindriya seeing means Aditya, Surya Devata is seeing. That is one Shruti. Ityadi Indriyanam Devata Adhina Cheshta Vatva Shruti. So Indriyas are functioning. Meaning Adityadi Devatas are functioning there. Indriyanam Devata Adhina Cheshta Vatva Shrute. And he says, okay, I'll not take it literally. Purapakshi says, okay, let me not take it literally. What does it mean though? Devata Adhina Cheshta Vatva Shrute. The Shruti says that there is Cheshta of the Indriya, Chakshur Indriya in this example. So in a sampled example, Chakshur Indriya has Cheshta, meaning has Kriya Vyapara, with the rupa of the vishaya, of the object. That rupa becomes vishaya for this chakshurindriya through the cheshta, and that cheshta is kamadhina, it is devata adhina. So kamadhina aditya devata madhina, cheshta is aditya devata adhina. That cheshta is dependent on the Aditya Devata, not dependent on the Jiva. So Jiva wants to see, but Aditya Devata is seeing. So he is the one who is actually helping see, not meaning if the Aditya Devata wants you to see, then you will see. Just because you want to see, you can't see. So this is the meaning there. He says, I will not take it literally, but what will it mean? Aditya Devata is helping you see, or he is making the Indriyas work. You cannot decide that I want to see. So Chakshur Indriya is not your Karana. It is at the mercy of Aditya Devata. Thereby, Ityadi Indriyanam Devata Adhina Cheshta Vatva Shrutehe Chakshusha Hi Rupani Pashyati. Kaha Jiva Pashyati. Jiva Chakshusha Hi Rupani Pashyati. Jiva Pashyati. Jiva Ha Pashyati. Jiva sees what? Rupani. How indeed he Chakshusha through the Chakshurindriya. So Chakshurindriya has become Karana to the Jiva. Now Chakshurindriya is Karana to Jiva, is also Anubhava Siddha. So Jiva sees using Chakshurindriya. However, what has been said? Adityas Chakshurbhutva. There is a contradiction. You see using your Chakshurindriya, but Aditya does not help, then how can you see? So it is not that dependent on you. So when you say Chakshushai Rupani Pashyati, Jiva Pashyati, then Jiva makes the Chakshurindriya work as Karana. He uses the Chakshurindriya for his own purposes. Thereby, there is a dependency of the Chakshurindriya functioning based on the Jiva. He controls the Chakshurindriya. Whether Jiva controls or Aditya controls, you tell me one thing. Shruti is telling me two things, therefore, which are contradictory. Telling me two different things which are contradictory. Therefore, Virodha Asti Navaiti Sandehe Asti Iti Purvapaksha. Virodha Asti says the Purvapakshi. Siddhanta Su Siddhanti says Jyotiradi Bihi Adityadi Devata Bihi. Sorry, Jyotiradi Bihi Adityadi Devata Bihi Adishtiyate there it does not mean that Aditya Chakshurbhutva does not mean that Aditya Devata is using the karanas, but what it means is that he blesses the indriyas to function the way Jiva wants if the prarabdha is conducive for him to see. If the Jiva has prarabdha to see, then Aditya Devata will help the indriyas function in that manner. So thereby adhishtiyate preryate. Adhishtiyate means what? Preryate. Therefore adhishtana means preranam. Adityadi devatadi devatabhi jyotiradi is adityadi. Jyoti means aditya there, surya. So through these devatas adhishtiyate preryate. Or by these devatas kartari tritya preryate karmani prayoga preryate adhishtiyate preryate. Indriyas are prodded to act by the devatas such as surya ityadi, based on which indriya is ruled over by that particular devata, and that is preryate iti adhishthanam. Karmani vyutpatti adhishtiyate iti adhishthanam, meaning adhishtiyate means preryate, preryate iti adhishthanam, that is the meaning there. And kena or kaihi preryate, so adhishthanam, this adhishthana is the indriyas which are having prerana by the devata, adhishtatur devata, and thereby adhishthitam eva devata adhishthita vagadikam cheshtate. So adhishthitam eva, this adhishthanam is what? Adhishthitam eva, preritam eva, that indriya which has vyapara, cheshta, cheshtate, indriyam cheshtate, indriya has vyapara. But which indriya has vyapara? Not any indriya will have vyapara. That indriya will have vyapara which is adhishtitam, means preritam. Only devata prerita indriya will have cheshta. That is why people may have golakas but may not have indriyas functioning. Indriya shakti is not there. Maybe from childhood or later also. Suddenly something may happen. So there the adhishtatra devata is not favoring because prarabdha is not there, that's all. So vagadikam cheshtate, vagadikam adhishtitam eva, preritam eva cheshtate, natu apreritam. And preritam kena preritam? Devata adhishtita vagadi. So devata prerita vagadikam cheshtate. The indriya which is favored, prodded by the Adhishtatru Devata alone has vyapara, not any indriya. Kutaha? How so? Why do you say so? Siddhanti says tadamananat. Tadamananat. Tasya amananat. That very idea has been said in the Shruti. We hear so in the Shruti itself. Adityas Chakshuhu. The example that you are giving, that itself is pramana. Adityas Chakshuhu Bhutva Ityadi Shrutya Abhidhanat. So that Shruti means that Aditya Devata gives prerana. That doesn't take away the Chakshurindriya being the karana of the Jiva. Just because there is a prerana, Jiva can close the eyes and not see. So Jiva has that free will. Jiva still uses the Chakshurindriya, Chakshuradi Indriyas as karanas, but they should be blessed by the Adhishtatra Devatas. Just because they should be blessed does not mean that it takes away the choice. There is a limited choice. There is a limited choice to see or not to see. If the indriyas are functioning, then there is enough choice. If they are not functioning, then what choice? But those who have choice, that choice is based on the independent jiva, svatantra karta. That karta can choose to see, not to see. With various indriyas, there is various set of limitations. Eyes can be closed and you may not see something that you don't want to see. Like that monkey emoticon who closes the eyes. So we can choose not to see. But if the light is, there's a noon light, you are standing in the noon sun and you are looking at the Surya, close the eyes, but still the light enters. You will see various colors, red, green, whatever, the color flashes will take place even with the closed eyes. So that is the choice that you have, but only up to that extent. Further, what we may choose not to hear and thereby close the ears. but still if the sound is loud, like the kids say, you know, they don't want to hear the sibling tease, so closes the ear, and then if that is not sufficient, starts to babble something, blah 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 blah. So the sibling is irritated and runs away, or tries a different manner to irritate, because Jiva's prarabdha is there to be troubled by his sibling. So you have so many choices with limitations also, choice is still there. So free will and this thing prarabdha works hand in hand there. As long as one does not, you know, does not have a choice to not make a choice, so long this free will is there, but still limited by the circumstances which are created by prarabdha. With you know, bad smell, we have seen this, you know, closing the nose may not work at all times, and so on. So adishtiyate preriyate iti adishtanam adishtitam eva, sorry, adishtitam eva devatadhi devatadhi adishtitat vagadikam cheshtate. So kutaha tadamanana tasya adityas chakshu ityadi shrutyabhidanat. Since the shruti says so, chakshushahi iti shrutyau tu. So the, what about the chakshushahi rupani pashyati, that shruti? So chakshushahi iti shrutau tu devatadishtitattva anishedhat na taya etasya virodha iti siddham. There is no virodha with the adhyatmika karanatva shruti. That shruti does not have virodha. There is no virodha with each other. Why? Because chakshushahi iti shruti, that shruti, chakshushahi rupani pashyati, that shruti is what? Iti shrutav, in that shruti tu devata adishtitattva anisheda. There is no nisheda being done. Is it saying that chakshushahi rupani pashyati, is it saying that that chakshur indriya is not blessed by the jyotiradi aditya? It is not saying so at all. So this chakshu can be aditya chakshur bhutva. We can, you know, make an anuruchi there and then say chakshusha, therefore what? Chakshu is aditya. Therefore we can say chakshusha kena chakshusha pashyati esha jiva rupani pashyati. We can say adityena rupena chakshusha. So adityena chakshusha hi rupani pashyati. There is no virodha. You can always say adityena chakshusha pashyati, because aditya chakshur bhutva has been mentioned. You can say chakshu is what? Nothing but aditya devata. Meaning Aditya Devata who is blessing the Chakshu. So you can say Adityena Chakshusha. You can say Chakshur Chakshuhu Indriya, which is what? Aditya Prerita. So Aditya Chakshusha means Aditya Prerita or Aditya Adishtita Chakshusha hi Rupani Pashyati. Where is the Virodha, sir? There is no Virodha at all. So that Shruti, Chakshushahi Rupani Pashyati, is not saying that Chakshur Indriya is not blessed by Jyotihi Adityaha. There is no such Vakya. Therefore, there is no Virodha at all. Both Shrutis can be read together and you can understand Devata Adishtitattva Anishedhat Chakshushahi Iti Shrutau Na Taya Etasya Virodha. So, Taya Shrutya Etasya Shruta Etasya Shrutyaha na virodha, Shrutyehe or Shrutyaha virodha nasti iti siddham. There is no virodha of Aditya Chakshur Bhutva Shruti with the Chakshushai Rupani Pashyati, because there is no statement such as doing Nisheda of the Aditya Devata being the Adishtatra Devata. We'll stop here and continue in the next part. आम्नायान्ते समसिद्धम आदिमध्यांत वर्जितम आनंदघनम आपूर्णम आत्मज्योतिरुपासमहे. नमस्ते, धन्यवाद.
ओके, धन्यवाद.